moment. I hope not. So
no.
Things definitely have turned around in a huge way for T1. We should be happy with that. So we do have the highlights ready to go. Let's hop into those and take a look at how this incredibly dominant game did play out.
And this is Riddick DRX opting into early skirmishing against the Renekton Nidalee Cult. That's not the way you want to go about it, especially not with your non-game position. Hecarim on level 4, yes, he's strong, but it's not really comparable to the raw power and versatility that you have. We saw some highlights from DRX, right? Like, there were some moments where they are actually attempted to the plays, and this is something that I think does really separate DRX besides the mechanical skill, is how they are a team that no matter what the game state is, they will look for plays. They will look for openings, and often they won't find them, but that 1 in 100, they will actually get through with it. And that's something that I think is, that's hard to create, right? Like, your team either has that or not. It's not something you can really build. And that's something that, as we go into the playoffs, could possibly still make DRX kind of a dark horse team where you're like, they're probably not going to make it. What if? You know? What if they do?
Yeah. And that's why these playoffs are getting more interesting by the match, right? Now that we have T1 who actually seem to be in form coming into playoffs at the perfect time, DRX, while they did lose this one, they had a great game one, and again, had one thing gone differently, maybe they win that game number one, and now we're going into a third game. Could be contenders. We could possibly have 6 teams that could challenge for that spring title, so playoffs get more and more interesting by the day. As these highlights, we already saw it happen. It's, you know, it's kind of just crazy T1 smacking them with their wallets because they're so far ahead. Like, not really much that DRX could do. They try to go for the Fnatic rushes, but they can only do so much here.
DRX is Mission Impossible. I guess Pioshik, that makes Pioshik their Tom Cruise, where he's trying to make make the impossible work. As already mentioned, it's simply too much. I love this. Like, it happens here, and it happened on top line, and then it also happens in a very minor fashion earlier on. You might look at this and go, like, what is DRX doing? But let's be honest, DRX have lost this game 100%.
Yeah.
I guess 99%, and they're looking for the 1% play, which should not work. And fortunately for T1, did not work. And T1, they look reinvigorated, right? Like, this is a roster where we know that they can perform. We know that they are incredible.